Hey guys, it's Heather. Welcome back to my channel. So I've been getting some questions a lot regarding how often I do certain things in regards to cleaning and organizing. So I figured the best way that I could address these questions is just to kind of sit down and film a video, just going through the questions and just talk a little bit about how often I do certain things. So I'll just kind of go through the list and just talk about each one. Before we get started, I just want to throw in a quick disclaimer. This is what works for me personally, so no judgments here. You may find what I do is excessive. You may say, you know, she doesn't clean enough or it's not enough. But again, this is just what works for me personally, so I just want to throw that out there before we get started. All right, so how often do I vacuum? I typically vacuum once a week. Sometimes it could be twice a week, but in the downstairs area where my dog lays and there's a lot of shedding going on, I do have a 160-pound bull mastiff. I do sweep every morning just because of the excessive amount of dog hair. And of course, if there's like Cheerios smashed all over the floor or things like that, I'll just kind of quickly spot clean. But as far as like vacuuming, it's typically done on a weekly basis. The next question, how often do I clean my bathroom? So including the shower and tub, I'll clean my bathroom once a week. As far as the shower and tub, that's done bi-weekly, so every other week. But as far as the shower and the tub goes, one of the key things is to make sure that you're drying off the shower and the tub. Like if you're using a squeegee on the shower doors, I literally just take a towel and just dry everything down. So then that way there isn't water left on the surface and you're giving like mold and mildew a chance to grow. And also those like mineral deposits, the hard water stains, you're not giving them a chance to develop. You're removing them and drying the surface. Like I mentioned in one of my last videos, I use vinegar every time after I shower. It's just a general shower spray. So I'll just literally spray it down and then just let it sit and kind of do its thing. Okay, so how often do I clean rooms that aren't used every day? So I guess that would be for me like my formal living room, dining room, and then we have a finished basement. So I would say for those areas, I typically will vacuum and dust them and just wipe the surfaces down like every other week. So like on a bi-monthly basis, because if they're not being used and no one's going in them, I just don't see the point in adding them to my weekly cleaning routine. So how often do I dust? I dust pretty much on a weekly basis. Sometimes it's done on a bi-weekly basis if I don't have that much time, but generally it is done on a weekly basis. And I use just the Swiffer dusters and I go around and I hit all the baseboards and then just like the furniture surfaces and that kind of thing. But I never let it go more than like 2 weeks. So let's see, how often do I clean my windows? So that would be referring to like the outside of the windows and then like the ledges. I will do that, let's say spring and fall. So before it starts to get cold and then when it starts to get warm, I will go through and I will clean all the dirt and gunk out of the ledges and then I will clean the outsides of the windows. Moving on, how often do I change my sheets? I change my sheets on a weekly basis and I change my daughter's sheets pretty much on a weekly basis too, just because she is three. Sometimes she has accidents, so sometimes I have to, you know, change them more than that. Clean my washing machine. I do that weekly because I find that after we wash our dog's bed, I wash my dog's bed weekly because it starts to smell and it's gross. So after I wash my dog's bed, I will go in right after and I will clean my washing machine to make sure that all the odors and all that gunk is out before I go ahead and put clothes in. How often do I declutter my closet? I typically declutter my closet seasonally. It depends. Sometimes I will go through and if I know that there's a couple things in there that I'm not really wearing, I will either just like turn the hanger around or mark them with like a little, I'll put like a little post-it and kind of tape it around the hanger just so that I know the next time I do like a big declutter that if I haven't worn those yet, that those ones would be going out. But typically it is done seasonally. But if I buy, so I have kind of like a one in, two out, or at least a one in, one out rule. So if I buy like a bunch of new clothes, because of the amount of hangers that I have, I refuse to buy any more hangers. I feel like I have plenty. So, and that kind of keeps my spending down and in check too. So it's like, if I know that I want to buy something, then I have to be prepared to declutter at least one. But, you know, for the most part, I try to do one in, two out. So how often do I organize and declutter my kids' room? Right now, that is pretty much, I would say, quarterly. So again, seasonally. She's right at the cusp of growing out of some things now. So as soon as that happens, I will kind of go in, take a look at everything in her drawers and her closet, and I will take out things that don't fit or that she's not wearing and just kind of reassess everything that she has in her room as far as toys, stuffed animals. I always like to make sure that things aren't getting too cluttered and that there's too much stuff going on in her room. So I always kind of like to keep it in check, and I do that probably like every few months, so like 4 times a year. Declutter my house, the same. So typically I will try to keep everything in check and just be aware of my surroundings, aware of what we have going on, and I try to keep up on it, because if you don't, it gets out of control, and then you're stuck doing quite a bit and you feel overwhelmed and the whole nine. So I try to do a little bit at a time. I try to do, I'd say like once a month, I'll just say, okay, let's look for 10 items and I'll go through my house. And I have been filming that process, so I will link it down below. I always feel better when there's less clutter. I don't know. I feel like if everything's cluttered around me, my mind is cluttered and I just can't focus as well. So I just like to kind of go through and keep things in check. And I would say like on a monthly basis, I will say, all right, let me take a look around. Let's make sure that we don't have too much going on that we're not using and that kind of thing. Okay. So how often do I clean my counters and surfaces? So as far as countertops, like in the kitchen and that kind of thing, I will clean them daily. Typically, I clean them every night, or I'll clean them every morning. It depends if the night before is like super busy and I'm tired. I'll just wait until the next morning, but I will give them a wipe down daily. As far as the other surfaces, like bathroom vanities and stuff like that, I would say like at least once a week, if not every other day. I have 5 bathrooms, so if it's a bathroom that's not being used a lot, some of those bathrooms get cleaned on a bi-weekly basis, but the bathroom downstairs, my master bathroom, and then my daughter's bathroom, I try to make sure that those surfaces are cleaned, I would say every other day. So moving on, how often do I clean my kitchen sink? I pretty much clean my kitchen sink daily because I'm constantly doing dishes and putting them in and out of the dishwasher. I just like to use my Palmolive dish soap and just kind of, you know, put it on a sponge and give it a good scrub, and then run the hot water, and I have one of like the sprayers, and I'll just kind of spray it out. And then I like to also kind of give it a spray down with alcohol to kill all the germs that are kind of hanging around in there. I don't know, I get like super kind of grossed out by the sink. So I just like to know that it's always clean. So yeah, that's what I do there. Moving on, so how often do I mop my floors? So that's done typically on a weekly basis. Again, areas that we're using that we're constantly, you know, walking through and they're getting traffic. Areas that we're not using, I won't do it as often, probably more like bi-weekly. If I'm really not using the area, like say down in my basement, we have tile, that will probably get done more on a monthly basis because no one's down there. But yeah, all the other areas like the bathroom tile and the kitchen wood floor, I really like to use the Bona. I do that on a weekly basis. So those are all the questions that I have to go through today. If you have any other ones, please leave it below in the comments section. So that's it for today's video. I hope that you guys found this helpful, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye, guys.